let's take a look at myhijabshot.com and what they have listed on their website. First, we'll see that it states, "You've asked for and we have listened. Here is the Moroccan abaya that is turning up a storm. It is casual and trendy abaya with a hood. Some call them hoodies. These abayas have all the flavor of Morocco. Featured with a beautiful front zipper and streamlined side pockets, you're going to love the look and feel of this one for years to come. Express yourself today and buy online with confidence." You're going to notice that these abayas do actually not have a zipper. And that was fine with me because I did not want one. You'll see on the website they start out by showing you a full view. We come down to two more views. And what I loved about this abaya is that because I live in the U.S. and because we're not always set up for men and women to be separated, there are times when we may have dinner parties and or have movie night or have game night where men and women are together. And I wanted a very casual abaya that I could just sit down and watch a movie in and not have to get out my pretty one for aid or for a party or for wedding. You know, I just wanted something casual. I wanted the jeans and hoodie version of an abaya, and I thought this one was going to be perfect. I'm going to zoom in on this picture on the right here so that I can show you exactly what I loved about this abaya. The number one thing that I loved about the abaya was the fact that it actually had a hood. I am a sucker for hoods. And the thing that I loved about this hood is that you'll see how it's made. The hood, or the edge of the hood, actually extends beyond this neckline. So you'll see here's the V neckline. The hood extends beyond it. And what this does is when the hood is down, it allows the edge to lay flat and not gather up towards your face, which is good for when you're not, for when you are wearing a hijab and have extra material around your face. The other good thing about this is that it allows the drawstring to lay nicely over the front of the abaya. And when you're wearing a plain casual abaya like this, you need as much detail on the outside, and these drawstrings provide that detail. Now, this is going to seem really silly to some, but I liked the casual look of the regular string with the frayed edges, just like you might find on your favorite college hoodie from your alma mater. That was one of the other details that really drew me to this. It wasn't too fancy. It was exactly what I was looking for. The other thing that I really liked were these sleeves. The sleeves were nice and full, like your favorite oversized hoodie would be. The cuff was brought in a little bit. You know, it wasn't one of those wide cuffs where if you go to wave to somebody, it's sliding all the way up your arm. It had a small cuff on it, similar to what you would find in a hoodie. And the sleeves were pleated really nicely around. So even though this was a casual abaya, you could tell whoever made this took the time to put specific pleats in those sleeves to help it lay nicely. Okay, now I'm going to bring up, see if I can do a split screen and bring up exactly what I received. I just filmed this today. Okay, now that we have seen what their website actually shows, I wanted to show you what I received in the mail. This is the blue. I'm hoping, let me turn on another light. I hope you can see the colors. That doesn't really help. But this is the navy blue, and I don't know if you can tell or see the fabric at all, but it feels like a cheap bed sheet, like one of those 150 thread count bed sheets that's more like sandpaper than an actual sheet. And this is what it feels like. And when you hold it up to the light, when you hold it up to the light, you can actually see through the fabric. Feeling a little blurry. I'm trying to film this on my camera because, believe it or not, this is actually better quality than my little webcam. And the black is made out of a totally different fabric than the blue one. It's like a rayon polyester type material, I think. So let's go through what's different.
I'm going to start off just by showing you the drawstring. The drawstring. This is what I received. That's not even close to what's... I actually would prefer the string, because I'm a fairly casual person, and I'm all about the details, and the string with the fringe at the end, I actually preferred that. I don't know, maybe other sisters would be different than me. The hood, you can see where the hood actually attaches to the neckline. There's no gap. So if you see how the string would actually lay, it doesn't lay over the abaya nice and neatly like it would in the picture, because you need the hood to be cut differently. It actually hangs on the inside. So, for me, that's a loss of detail. Because I do order such basic things that there's a lot of detail missing in there. But, I mean, the hood's okay, I guess. It's a nice big hood. They did double the fabric, so you don't see weird seams. You'd have to clip some stuff, obviously. Let me go down to the sleeves now. The sleeves, let's see if you can see it. I hope the camera picks it up. The sleeve is just a basic straight sleeve. And there's not a whole lot of room there. See, it's not nice and thick. If I were to take my hoodie off that I'm wearing now and put it down, I mean, look at my, I don't know if you can see my sleeve. See how my hoodie sleeve is? Nice and thick. It's got a lot of volume. It hides your shape well. It's like a tube sock. The cuff in the picture was a nice thick cuff, probably at least from here to here, I would say. Maybe a good inch or almost 2 centimeters wide is what the picture showed. And these cuffs just have a little teeny tiny elastic in it. The sleeves in the picture were nicely pleated. This is just gathered. See, if I stretch out the elastic, the fabric stretches out. It's just, there's no, they basically just did a running stitch and then threaded an elastic through. And the same with the black abaya, except when I tried this one on, I had it on for 2 minutes and the elastic snapped. So I'm left with a broken sleeve, which would it probably actually fit better than this gather, because it's so tight. Yeah. See how tight it is around my wrist? It's tight. Wanted to show you the edge of, this is the bottom of the black abaya. When they sewed it, and I'm all for, I don't mind handcrafted, and I don't mind little things here and there, because I think it creates character, but when you receive something that's not even of the same material, and the difference in material results in a different look, I guess that's where I start to have my problem, and I don't like all the puckering around the base of the abaya there. I'm going to show you the, I don't know if it'll show on the black, but these are the same type of drawstring on the black. The hood is sewn the same way. Let's see if I can get it in focus. There we go. I'm sorry if this video is giving you a headache. So anyway, those are the abayas that I ended up receiving. In my opinion, the abayas on the website are probably made by a different manufacturer, and whoever sewed these made up their own pattern to try to mimic it, but the details are just missing. It's not made the same. The material it's awful. The quality just isn't there. And I would have to say that waiting this long to get something that I could have sewn myself, I could have done this.
Now that I have received the abaya, I can update my customer satisfaction review. Unfortunately, the results don't change. The order processing, I still remain neutral because I still am not sure whether or not they took this entire time to process it, or if it took this long because it was being shipped from Egypt. Speedy delivery, absolutely a one. Extremely dissatisfied with that. I ordered this on August 6th, and I did not receive it until September 13th. The packaging was okay, nothing spectacular, especially where it was coming so far. It was just in a shipping bag. The product quality, I'm extremely dissatisfied with it for the reasons that I showed you. Customer experience, even though I did receive them, my customer experience is still very dissatisfied. I never received a response to my 3 emails, to the 2 forms I filled out online, nor has anybody ever been available to answer the phone. So out of a possible score of 5, or an average of 5, they scored a 1.8, which still brings us to a dissatisfied experience. Should you choose to order through myhijabshop.com, I would suggest not basing your expectations on the pictures that are shown on their website. I certainly hope that your experience is far better than mine was, and that the products you order are exactly what you're looking for. Masalama.